the surgical floor. The theaters are in here.
We all remember that aftermath of this emergency, Safaricom, as a company who is a corporate leader in this country, had offered to fundraise through M-Pesa, and we know after a period of a week, 72 million Kenya shilling was raised by the Kenyan public, and then Safaricom Foundation and M-Pesa Foundation topped it up by 30 million, so we had 102 million that was collected through the M-Pesa platform. In addition to that, Kenyan corporates and individuals also have been donating, and as of this afternoon, we had collected a total of 123 million Kenya shillings. We were able to disburse so far. What we paid this morning was about 28.6 million that had been approved and authorized and audited by Deloitte and Touche, and another 19 million, which will bring to a total of 47 million Kenya shilling that we have disbursed or will have disbursed by the end of the day today. So the large part of this fund of up to 60 million will go into hospital bills for patients who could not afford to pay. We know there are patients who could afford to pay on their own, and there are patients who are on insurance, and here we'd like to encourage the insurance companies to endeavor to pay for the patients who are covered with them, who have been discharged from hospitals or those are still in hospital, and that is something the hospitals are working directly with the insurance company. So for the patients that could not afford to pay is what we have paid, and this is the initial amount paid to three hospitals, Aga Khan, MP Shah, and Mata, that have been paid this 28.6 million Kenya shillings, which has gone through a vetting process. When the hospital presented the bills, Deloitte and Touche, also I'd like to thank from the outset, who have agreed to do this on pro bono basis, were checking and vetting all these invoices. We also approved a 19 million Kenya shillings today to do with Kenyatta National Hospital and National Blood Transfusion Services, bringing a total of close to 47 million, what has so far been then approved and expensed. In addition to that, there are other costs that have been approved of 15 million that would go for psychosocial support, counseling, and trauma for people who have been directly and indirectly affected by this tragedy and this disaster in hospitals, outside hospitals, first responders, and that is being worked on now. And a program is being rolled out that will be a long, mid to long term program. Numbers of bodies that have been counted as dead, in whatever shape or form they were found or where they were found. Those who died in these hospitals and the ones who are taken direct to Sichi mortuary, the numbers have been reconciled to 67. So the DNA that's forensic is something that's taking a longer time. That I think you need to go to the police to inquire from them. The blood that was collected countrywide, private, public, hospital, countrywide, is 17,240 units of blood was collected. Thank you for coming.